I'm Meredith Fagan of the Venn Sea Turtle Program.
I'm Kate Mansfield, and I've been with the Sea Turtle Program for 8 years. We have multi-aspects to the program here at VIMS, and one aspect has been maintaining the State Stranding Network database and also participating as coordinators in the State Stranding Network. During the stranding season, which is from May through October, we'll respond to a number of strandings that are called in by the general public. We're able to monitor trends over time in terms of stranding numbers, in terms of species composition, how many turtles are coming into the bay and found stranded. The other aspect that we've been doing is a research component. There's been a strong emphasis on habitat utilization. We've looked at dive behavior and in-water habitat use. This program has done diet studies. We've looked at the ecology of the animals, what these animals are eating, tagging studies. Because they're living such oceanic lifestyles, one method of observing where they go is by tagging them. When we release this animal, maybe it'll be found down in the Gulf of Mexico, maybe it'll be found in North Carolina. We know that that animal will have utilized those habitats. If this animal that we release today is caught again, we'll be able to determine the size of the animal and determine how much this animal has grown.
For the tagging procedure, we use something called inconal flipper tags.
They're actually cattle ear tags. The other tag that we used was pit tag, which is a passive integrated transponder. Right. And it's this little glass capsule that has a barcode encrypted in it. And it's the same thing as when you're checking out at a grocery store. Something gets scanned and it goes beep, and it's the exact same thing that vets use when they microchip pets. Chesapeake Bay is known as a very important juvenile developmental area for sea turtles, and that includes both loggerheads and Kemp's Ridleys. We have so little information on where these animals go, what their offshore ecology and habitat use is. Essentially, we see turtles when they're on the nesting beach as adult females nesting. We see the hatchlings, and then they move offshore as soon as they've hatched out, and we don't see them again for a number of years. There are four or five species that have been found in the Chesapeake Bay or Virginia waters. All of them except for one are listed as endangered. The loggerhead is the only one that is listed as threatened, which is a step below endangered.
What we're mainly focusing on is on attempting to rehabilitate and release live turtles that are stranded, as well as to maintain a database of the dead stranded sea turtles. That allows us then to understand what the causes of sea turtle mortalities are, and so that we can hopefully prevent them in the future.
Sea turtles, because they eat some of the stuff that many of the fishermen fish for, including whelk and blue crabs, have the potential to interact with many of the fisheries that are out in the bay. Also, sea turtles can interact with humans when people are riding around in boats or sea dews if they happen to hit a sea turtle.
Without the VIMS Sea Turtle Stranding Program, then we wouldn't be getting the types of information from either research or the stranding data that we need to try to recover or foster the recovery of sea turtles.